Welcome back. Okay, this is the old setup. Calculated transports, calculated material. Now we have tracks here. We have a new scenario and we can remove some of the producing machines here. And then we can calculate how many transport in the new situations are necessary. Your task is to find out old situation costs and timing and frequency of transports and energy and everything and the new system.
Can I have an overview of the whole factory?
Ah, good idea. This is a central warehouse. Okay, here. Here's a central warehouse, research facility. In this area, electronic components, interesting to know, not for this problem important, is my old factory and I'm doing some optimization. That's one of the next steps. Is it important for us now? No, we only take care for the research and they are only for the pink and the gray packages. All the other parts, interesting, but not for your problem. Here is my energy park. These are accumulators and these are solar panels. Here I have an old energy production. I have an atomic plant. Then here is a furnace area. We can produce bricks, steel, iron. The only possibility to produce tracks will be here because here are stones. Here is the local warehouse with iron plates. So from iron plates, we can make steel. From iron plates, we can make the iron sticks. And then they have to produce here. Research, central warehouse, furnace area. Okay, what is the rest? These are my copper mines. You see, everything is standing still. Old iron mine. I started a new one here. You can see the pollution. The pollution is red. You see, not working, no pollution. Then we need coal. Coal we get over here. In night, there's no light. I have decentralized also solar parks and accumulators. It's the mines for uranium ore. And here is a production of energy cells for the atomic reactor. There's also a chemical industry, producing acid and also some oils. And then I had started a new facility here. As you see, my factory is not so big. If you see other videos, you see they're very, very big factories. So this is the whole factory, the producing part of it. And the setup we used for the examination in logistics data analysis. I explained a little bit what we can see here in this part. There is my solar park with solar panels. Here the dark, the light gray are correlators. So I have here a classic coal plant. An atomic plant. As you remember, there was a tutorial about buffers and controlling buffers. This was the green series. This is the part where we can see all the logic behind it. This was the tutorial number one. And we learned about buffers. The second is the sushi belt solution for the research facilities. Number two. This is the third tutorial. I'm working now on it. It also explains the pull logic, but the difference is that we here now have not separated buffers with one material, we have now mixed buffers. What is also in our layout here in this part, is the old factory. I will make some lines on it because I'm now removing it to create a more efficient one. Okay, this is set up. What is also important for our problem, here we have the new central warehouse. I will call it WH for warehouse. In the warehouse, all materials, basic materials are stored. Also the stones and the bricks. And the question was, is it really intelligent to have stones here in the expensive warehouse? In this area is also a small warehouse. We have 18 furnaces, and these 18 furnaces here in this area can produce copper plates, iron plates, bricks, and steel. So the question is, stones are here, stones are here, stones are here. Bricks are produced here, are stored here, and are produced here. Is this really intelligent to have basically the same material at different places? More efficient to produce some tracks, and tracks are stones, and tracks are steel, there's iron. Store them in the central warehouse, send them to the research facilities. We have the whole setup, also the tutorials. You can see the links below. Have some fun, and if there are any questions, don't hesitate to ask them. Bye.